Now, this video is for somebody who's been out on the trails for a couple of weeks, maybe a month or two, and I want to talk about the three mandatory ingredients in a good training program. So, you're looking to improve your riding. What do you need to do? Well, the first ingredient is consistency. If your aim is to increase your threshold power, you need to be consistent. This means you need to stick to your training program day after day, week after week, month after month, for however long it takes to reach that goal that you set. Significant improvements of threshold power won't happen overnight, so take a long-term approach. Each workout should take you a little bit closer to your goal. Keep in mind, if you really want to improve your threshold power and cycling abilities overall, you need to be patient. Allow yourself the time to improve and reach your cycling goals. Commit to work hard each and every day you hop on your bike and make sure you do your best to maximize your results. Some days you want to you want to go for hard rides, some days you want to go for easy rides. That's what I'm really talking about. The second ingredient is structure. One of the best ways to achieve overall results without working harder is to add structure to your training. A solid training plan is both motivating and will boost your overall threshold. If you don't think you can stick with a structured program, then you might be better off with a different type of approach. That could be by making Tuesdays and Thursdays your interval days and Saturdays and Sundays your days for long rides. You will get some basic structure in your training that will accelerate your progress. This is much better than riding without any structure or training plans. The third ingredient is interval training. This is probably the most important and the one that people really don't focus on. Interval training is my favorite way to boost my threshold power. Adding structured interval training two or three times per week will help you ride significantly faster within 4 to 6 weeks. The majority of intervals should be sub-threshold intervals. Although there's no doubt that adding these threshold power and VO2 max intervals to your training program very likely might be the missing ingredient to reaching that to your overall potential. So what I'm really looking at here is you get on and you ride hard, ride easy, you ride hard, you ride easy, and you're pushing yourself. If you don't have the time, then a few distance paces will help you out. But make sure you're doing this aerobic exercise at least two times a week. I'm pretty sure that the above three ingredients should be the cornerstone in your daily training routine. Take advantage of these simple but very effective and proven methods to improve your overall performance. And those, once again, were consistency, structure, and interval training. This is Cycling Explorer, and I hope you have a great day.